to visit.
Where do you call home?
Where do you call home?
Tona Ohama lays down the tracks for his own records in the basement of his parents' house on a potato farm on the plains of Rainier, Alberta. He records all the sounds himself, and like Thomas Dolby, Howard Jones, and Laurie Anderson at the start of their careers, he performs solo on stage. Ohama gave a rare performance at Toronto's Rivoli Club recently. He only ever uses his backing tracks once, offering bunches of it to his audience as a souvenir.
I feel better than I'm feeling right now. I feel worse too, but that can't comfort me now. Look to the kitchen, see some breadcrumbs and a knife. Look to the window, it's like a movie.
A picture that I conjured up about your recording was that you had this underground recording studio underneath a farmhouse in the middle of this vast prairie, like some kind of post-apocalyptic vision. Is that at all what it's like?
Yeah, that's exactly what it looks like. It does. I think of The Wizard of Oz. Remember Dorothy and The Wizard of Oz way out in the middle of Kansas?
Yes.
That's something like what it is.
And the tornado comes along, the twister.
Yeah, the twister. Well, no twister, but... It's very much the same geography, and I feel the same sort of situation. It's like being in a movie or something. And I really like it, because I could come to a city like Toronto and visit, and then go home to the isolation again. I think you get a lot of power growing up in a place like that. Not just personal power. It's not like living in the city. And I also think that being isolated, I'm not affected by a lot of things, which is... It's bad on the one hand because you don't get all the influences, but it's good on the other hand, you can focus a lot better. I don't get caught up in the trends and things so much.
Many of your songs have found sound in them or a soundtrack feel to them. Sounds like lapping water or a conversation or a TV left on or this sort of thing. What is your attitude towards those other kinds of sounds that aren't conventional music sounds?
I've been influenced by Brian Eno in that he says that you can use anything. If you use it properly, then it's valid. It doesn't have to be a musical sound. And I agree with that a lot. And especially the industrial music, the noise music that comes out, I really like that sort of thing.
Like Cabaret Voltaire and The Art of Noise?
I like Anstruss and the Neubauten.
Ah, yes.
I like just noise. Maybe it comes from hearing so much music, then I get tired of it. I just want to hear something that's not so musical.
I can hear it. I can see it moving. I can feel it touch me.
You have a very ambivalent attitude about television. You've said in interviews before that you like television, but on the other hand, your songs about TV are quite aggressive, and you have been known to put a hockey stick into a TV set and destroy it.
It's a terribly wonderful thing, television.
A terribly wonderful thing.
A terribly wonderful thing. I think that in the country, it's your major contact with the outside world.
taking over from the radio in the prairies once upon a time.
Yeah. Definitely. Everybody watches a lot of television when they live on a farm. And so it's good because you're entertained and you're informed, but you know how colored it is. It just gives one view of the world, and that's not necessarily a good thing. So I really enjoy watching television, but I don't
you're
like
suspicious
it.
Of it.
I am.
Careful in the way you watch it.
I watch it a lot differently now than I used to. Often I turn the sound off and just watch the technical part of it.
That's very interesting. Would you recommend that to most people?
I think so, yeah. It's a much better way to watch television because then you're not affected by it as much, but you're entertained by it.
I don't know what I'm saying. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what I'm thinking. I'm getting tired of wasting my time, my time, my time. My time, my time, my time.